Welcome, Selmos, to another incredible Sunday in the best place in the entire world here at your church. Selmos, we're so excited that you're joining us. Hey, do me a huge favor right now. I want you like, subscribe, comment, share the message to whoever you love the most in the entire world. And thank you so much for joining us. If this is your very first time here, we want to welcome you. We hope that you feel at home. We would love to get to know you, but it's online. So why don't you give us a shout out via text on the number right here below, and just say your number, your name, email, so that we can get to know you a little bit better. Welcome to our church. We have an exciting announcement, church family. This Thursday, we are having our last Connect group before we go into the summer. Now, I can hear you all saying, oh, yes, but not really, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring all the different Connect groups into one group. We're gonna have a big mega Connect group every single Thursday starting June 4th. Starting June 4th, it's gonna be all of us together in the same place, and we're gonna just learn a little bit more about church, get to know each other a little bit better and better. But you don't wanna miss out. Every single Thursday, we have a date, so we want to see you there. It's not going to be the same without you. We are super excited. And the season that we're in right now as a church, we're doing church online. We're doing some outreach that is really great and incredible. We're doing our Connect groups every single Thursday, and it's going to evolve into this big thing I just talked about. But one of the cool things that I really love is that we are in a series called Don't Stop Building. You know, and with that series, one of the really cool things, you know, is that every single time that we're building something, we don't want to stop, right? And I'm going to take this moment right now, first of all, to thank every single one of you that literally from the beginning have partnered with us financially, and you give week after week. This church, everything that's happening here today, would not be here if it wasn't because of your generosity. So come on, church, isn't that incredible that every single thing that you give goes into making this thing happening and impact people, inspire people, love on people, talk to people about God. There's a really big reality, you know, and I love this reality, is that every single one of us, we are living based on the sacrifice of other people's sacrifice. You know, you and I today, we are literally enjoying this country, this freedom that we have in this country, you know, of religion and speech and so many different things, right? We are truly blessed in the United States of America. And it's all because of other people that sacrificed. You know, Jesus, it's our biggest example in this world. And we live today the way we live because of his sacrifice. Every single human in this world enjoys life in a certain way because of others' sacrifice. And you and I, we always want to be so thankful for all the people that have sacrificed before us, but we want to make sure that we don't only sit and enjoy other people's sacrifice. We want to make sure that today we're sacrificing as well, so that some people in the future will reap the harvest of that sacrifice. That's what building a legacy is all about. That is, as a church, why we don't want to stop building. We're constantly building because we're constantly trying to reach people and for other people to encounter the love of God that you and I have encountered. So today I want to invite you with gratitude from the past, from other people's sacrifice from the beginning, right? They've sacrificed so much to make church happen, right? And you and I enjoy that. So today we're going to be thankful for that. But at the same time, today we're going to sow seed in good ground. Today we're going to sacrifice our tithes and our offerings. We're going to do it joyfully and gladly because we know that everything we give in the future it's going to impact other people. So today's somos you can give online via somoschurch.cc/give, or you can do so via the Cash App as well at Somos Church. Somos today, I'm super pumped because we have incredible worship. And also my wife has a message that's gonna impact you in a really awesome way. Love you all, let's tune in.
Just one word, you calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see, my heart can't help but believe.
There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Just one more. You hear what's broken inside every time. Oh, just one word, and you revive every dream. Just one touch, I feel the power of heaven. Just one touch, come on. My eyes were open to see, my heart can't help but believe.
There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Oh, I know there's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a prison wall He can't break through. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Oh, I believe, I gotta believe. Come on, with faith we sing. And I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Yeah. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of
come
Jesus.
Come on, someone sing with us.
Now we'll believe, come on. For greater things, there's no power like the power of Jesus. So let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree.
There's no power like His power. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Hey!
There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way.
There's nothing that Jesus can't do. I know
there's nothing that can't do. There's not a prison wall He can't break through. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do.
Come on, everybody, sing.
Sing, oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, o
right where you're at, if you're sitting down or standing, worship with us. God, we invite you, we honor you, and we believe that you are still the God of miracles. Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. And your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. And your voice is calling me out right now. I know you're able, and my you've never lost a battle, and I know, you never will. Anything's possible by the power of the Holy Ghost. A new wind is blowing right now, tearing my heart of stones, taking over like it's Jericho, and my walls are all crashing down. And right now, I know you're able, and my God, come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail, 'cause you've never lost a battle. No, you've never lost a battle, and I know, you never will. Come on, someone, sing this next part with us. You've never lost a battle. You've never lost a battle. You've never lost a battle. You never will. You've never lost a battle. You've never lost a battle. You've never lost a battle. You can do all. You can do all things. You can do all things but fail, 'cause you've never lost a battle. No, you've never lost a battle, and I know, you never will. Yes, I know, you never will. Yes, I know, you never will. You can do all things. You can do fail, 'cause you've never lost a battle. No, you've never lost a battle, and I know, you never will.
Hello, Somos. I am so excited that you are joining us here for another incredible Sunday gathering, church and home. You know, it's been almost 2 months that we've been in this incredible online experience. And I just want to say that I am so thankful to every single one of you who have been tuning in week after week. We're so pumped about our new series called Don't Stop Building. And today I'm going to add another layer into this incredible series. So I pray that you will open up your heart and receive everything that God has in store for you today. So let's get right to it. And, you know, there has been several decisions that I have made during quarantine in my personal life, and I never thought that I would be saying this today, but I'm going to say it. One of the decisions that I have made is to learn how to cook. Come on, all you moms, all you ladies that know me in the house, you should be so proud of me. Instead of cooking quesadillas now, I can actually, you know, step it up a little bit and I can make some enchiladas, you know. Instead of helping Sergio while he's making breakfast, just put like butter and jelly on the toast, I can actually make some bacon now. I'm so proud of myself. I know that this may seem ridiculous to some of you, but for me, it is a huge step and it's a decision that I've made. And I've loved it because even through cooking and learning how to cook, I've bonded a lot with my daughter, and I've been able to give my husband a little break in the kitchen. So how many of you guys have made some decisions during quarantine? You know, I put it on my Instagram and I just wanted feedback from different people, and some of the decisions that other people have made during quarantine was to read more books. Someone said that they would be showering every day. I won't say who that is, but you know, if that's a decision you're making, I am proud of you. Someone said that they are making the decision of making their bed every day, of being healthy, of working out. I asked my daughter what decisions has she made, during quarantine. And she said to pray more and to help people so they can trust and know God. Shout out to Sophia. That's an awesome decision to make during this time. You know, every decision that you and I make has either a positive or a negative consequence. And today I wanna title my message, One Decision at a Time. You know, you and I have the power to make these decisions. And like I said, they're either going to positively impact us or they're going to negatively impact us. But today I want us to focus on this thought, and it is the power of generational decisions. What does this mean? It sounds intense, but if you break it down, what this means is that the decisions that you and I make today have the power to impact the next generations to come. You know, it is the power of me saying today, I want to follow Jesus, and tomorrow that affecting my daughter, my kids, my family. You know, in my personal life, I have decided to say yes to God in my life, in my calling, in my job. And this wasn't a decision that I made overnight. You know, some of you may know I grew up in church, but then I totally kind of backslid and did my own thing. And it wasn't until I was 19 years old where I said, you know what, God, do whatever it is that you want to do in my life. And so I can now see that the power of that decision has impacted my next generation, which is my daughter. And I am so proud of you all, because I know that a lot of you guys watching today are making that decision or have made that decision. But I want us to start thinking about the power of our decisions instead of seeing them as a momentary repercussion, to see it. How is my decision today gonna affect me in the long run? How is it gonna affect my kids, my family in the long run? And I think that if we start to think that way, we're gonna begin to grow. We're gonna begin to make wiser and smarter decisions in our life. Can someone say amen? You know, every decision that you and I make has a price tag. Every decision will cost you time, energy, money, resources, your reputation, your talent. There is always an investment to be made when we make decisions. So we cannot, you know, take decisions lightly in our life. And, you know, that's why I think it's so important to have a process when making decisions. And today, I just want to get so practical with you guys. I don't want to come here and, you know, share this message message and empower you to make the right decisions. And you're like, Beatrice, how in the world do I make the right decisions? You know, because I believe that all of us need help in, you know, this area of our lives, which is to make the right decisions. So I'm going to kind of give you guys a little bit of a formula, something that has worked in my life and something that Sergio and I always advise to other people when making decisions. So if you're taking notes right now, you want to write the first step in making a decision is to pray for guidance. Proverbs 28:26 says, "Those who trust their own insight are foolish, but anyone who walks in wisdom is safe." Before you do anything, get God's guidance on the issue. Pray about it. How many times do we think, you know, oh, I want to do this, or an opportunity pops up, or oh, I want to live here, I want to go there, and we just go with the flow of things, right? We just get focused. I want that, and I'm going to do it. And rarely do we stop and think, God, what is it that you want? Is this a decision that I should make? Open the door. You know, so many times we make a decision and then we ask God to bless it, you know? So today I want to encourage you. Step number one in making a decision in your life, pray about it. You can never go wrong with prayer. And I promise you that if you invite God into your decision making, he will lead you and he will guide you. So number two, in your process of making a decision, get the facts. Again, so many times we have something that pops up and we're like, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to, you know, go there. And before you even like research the place, I did this, unfortunately, in a very important decision in my life. When I got accepted to my first university, when I was a senior in high school, I remember that I just wanted to get out of El Paso. I was like, I don't care what I need to do. The first university that accepts me, I am going there. And sure enough, you know, I got accepted to a university in Fort Worth. And don't judge me, okay? I was just like a lost person, so just don't judge me. But I didn't really do much research on this university. I just signed up for orientation, and my parents were, okay, you want to go there? We're going to make it happen. And I get there, okay, a week before classes start. And they had an orientation for students and parents. And I am walking down this campus, and I am so overwhelmed, you guys. I am like, I cannot believe that I'm going to stay here, like freaking out internally. Like, I did not want to let go of my parents, you know? But I didn't have a choice. I mean, it was what it was, and I signed up for my classes, and I'll never forget them driving off when they, you know, it was the last day we said goodbye. And it was a really hard time for me, to the point that I was only there for one semester. So I want to encourage you, do your research, know what you're going for, get the facts. It is wise to find out all you can before you make a decision. And Proverbs 13:16 says, "Wise people think before they act. Fools don't, and they even brag about their foolishness." So let's be people that think before we act. And the third practical way that I want to encourage you to make decisions today is to ask for advice. Proverbs 24:16 says, "So don't go to war without wise guidance. Victory depends on how many advisors you have." And so today, I want to encourage you, before you make a decision, especially if it's a big decision in your life, ask for advice. Get around people that are maybe wiser than you, older than you, that love you and have your best interests at heart, and open up your heart and get some godly counsel. You know, so many times we go to the people that we know are going to tell us what we want to hear, and that will feel so good good in the moment and we know who to call. But I just want to encourage you, be courageous and talk to people that are going to tell you, you know, what they need to tell you in love, of course. But it's wise to always ask for advice, you know. Something that I've learned in my life is that I can learn from making my mistakes, but I'd rather learn from someone else's mistakes, right? Their life is too short to go and try to figure it out on our own. So today, I want to challenge you to make decisions with this process. Pray for guidance, get the facts, and ask for advice. And, you know, with that said, I'm going to talk to you guys about some of the most important decisions that we're going to have to make in our life. And I believe that, you know, as we continue to build and as we continue to just take these steps of faith that God is asking us to take in our personal lives and as a church, there are going to be these tough decisions and these tough crossroads that we're going to find ourselves in. But if we are equipped and encouraged, then we are going to be able to build on the foundation, which is Jesus, to build on that solid rock, which is Him and Him alone. And so, you know, I put on my Instagram, what are some of the decisions that, you know, people are making out there? And what are some of the most important decisions? And some of them were a little bit off. Well, okay, they weren't off. This person was not off, but this person said something about putting, sorry if you're listening. They said one of the most important decisions they'll make in their life is whether they'll put mustard or ketchup on their hot dog. Okay, I don't know. But, you know, a little bit more serious. Sergio's cracking up at me right now. I'm so sorry. Okay, so number one, one of the most important decision that we will make in life is following Jesus, you know? This is by far the greatest decision that you'll make. Jesus will heal, deliver you, strengthen you, back you up. He will do what no one else can do in your life. I found in my personal life that when I made the decision to follow Jesus, He completed me. You know, there was so many areas in my life that felt so unfulfilled. And the moment that I said, Jesus, I need you, everything started to change. And I believe that a lot of us, that has been our story. Maybe you're watching today and you're on the fence. You're like, who is this Jesus? Should I have a relationship with Him? Should I give my life to Him? I just want to encourage you, you will never regret giving your life to Jesus. He gives your life purpose. I don't know about you, but I know that sometimes we can wonder so much, what is my purpose? What in the world am I called to do? When you make the decision of bringing Jesus into your life, He gives you purpose. He gives you freedom. He gives you everything that you will ever need to do what God has put you on this earth to do. Colossians 2:10 says, in Christ, you have been brought to fullness. He is head over every power and authority. And then James 1:17 says, every good and perfect gift is from above. When you invite Jesus into your life, you will inherit this promise that says that every good and perfect gift also belongs to you. Your decision to follow Jesus will impact you for the rest of your life, and it will impact the people around you. I have seen time and time again, people say, I'm going to live for Jesus. And then their families start to live for Jesus and they start to be transformed and renewed and changed. It is one person's decision. And today I want to encourage you, if maybe you're making this decision right now, or maybe you think, oh, man, I should have made this decision earlier when my kids were younger, or, you know, if I should have just known about this before I, you you know, got married or when I was going through, you know, that tough situation, it is never too late to invite Jesus into your life. And this is a generational decision that you can choose to make today. That maybe, you know, your kids are older, married, and today you make the decision to follow Jesus, it'll still have a generational impact on their lives and on their kids' lives. So I just want to encourage you today. Let's make Jesus the number one decision in your life. There is nothing that will compare to him. There's no hard work, no job, no money in the bank, no popularity that can do what only Jesus can do in you and through you. The second most important decision that you'll make in your life, if Sergio was preaching this message, he would say, what are we eating for lunch today? But since he's not preaching, right, I just want to encourage you with this. The second most important decision you will make in your life is who you will marry. Come on, someone say amen. I'm talking to all the single people out there. I'm talking to the people that are in relationships that are not married yet. You will make the second most important decision by choosing who you will marry. And what I love about this is that we get to choose who we will marry. Unless you are in an arranged marriage, then this does not apply to you. But who you will marry will directly impact the rest of your life. Who you will marry will directly impact your calling in God. Who you marry today will directly have an effect on the rest of your life. So I want to encourage you today to make a wise and smart decision. We're not in a relationship series, so I'm not going to go all in on this one. But I believe that our season of singleness before we're married is such an incredible opportunity for us to discover who we are in God, to discover our gifts, our talents, and then to give them kingdom purpose. To say, okay, I am an awesome entrepreneur. How can I use this to help others, to love others? I'm an incredible artist, musician. How can I use my talents for the glory of God? Or maybe you're just incredible at, I don't know, planning events, or you have all these gifts and talents. In your singleness, it is your time to discover that and give them a purpose in God. So when that person comes along, your dreams should align with their dreams, right? Your passions should align with their passions. Singleness is not a time of loneliness. And I just want to encourage somebody right now who may be single and you've been feeling lonely, right? You've been having maybe the temptation or the craving to just DM somebody or respond to those DMs. Singleness is not a season of loneliness. I believe that God wants to do something incredible in your life right now. If you would just say, God, I'm giving that to you. I'm giving that area to you. I want your best for my life, not what I think is best. You know, during this time of singleness, whether you are young or older or whatever your situation is, I believe that God is developing character in you. He is building strength in you. He is developing disciplines in you. You know, he is getting you emotionally healthy. So when that person comes along, you are ready and you are not going to try to find fulfillment in that person, but instead you're going to complement each other and walk towards the things that God is calling you to do. So in this season, single people, remember that who you marry is so important. So invest in yourself, prepare yourself, and become the best version of yourself. And if it's a desire that you have in you to get married, to find Mr. Right or Mrs. Right, Psalms 37:4 says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. As you're delighting yourself in God, God's desires become your desires. It's just a matter of timing. So be patient. Become who you need to be in God, and God will take care of the rest. And lastly, I believe that the daily decisions that we make are so important because they will impact our tomorrow. If there is stress that you are carrying every single day, I want to encourage you to give that to God, because that stress that you're carrying today is going to impact your tomorrow. If there's worry all the time, you're worried, you're frustrated, you're on edge today, I encourage you to say, God, I give you this worry. If there is a daily decision that you have to make in God, to trust in Him, today I want to encourage you to declare it. You may not feel it, but you can speak it. God, I trust you. I trust you in my finances. I trust you in my relationships. I trust you in my marriage. Even when you don't feel it, you can declare it over your life. And there is power in that. And that will unleash a faith in you that maybe you didn't have right now. You know, the daily decisions that we make will impact our tomorrow. Where do you invest your time? You know, this is so important. Where do you spend most of your time today? If I was to come to your house and sit down and have some coffee with you, where would that time be invested? Because where you invest your time today is where you will see fruit tomorrow. So if you're investing in TV all day or talking, I don't know, to random people all day, and which is, you know, it's awesome to invest in other people, but if you are not investing in yourself and in your relationship with God, then it's going to be really hard to build what God is asking you to build right now. You know, maybe a decision that you have to make today is to live in purity and holiness. And I know that this is a tough one, but with God, you can do it. With God and with an incredible support system, you can do it. Today, I want to encourage you that it is in the daily decisions that you make that will have a generational impact in your life tomorrow. So let's be people. Let's be men and women that say, God, I'm going to trust you with my daily decisions, right? So three most important decisions in your life is number one, following Jesus. Number two, who you will marry. And number three, the daily decisions that you make. And I want to encourage you with this. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths. Today, whatever it is that is frustrating you, that is burdening you, that is not allowing you to take that next step in God, the thing that is keeping you up at night, I want to challenge you and encourage you to say, God, I give it to you. Help me in this decision that I have to make, or with this worry, with this fear. Hand it over to God and allow Him to build in you a legacy that will last for generations to come. It is one decision at a time, one day at a time. Take this message and take some self-inventory of the things that you need to change, of the decisions that you need to make for good. Surround yourself with people that are going to encourage you, that are going to give you wise advice. And I promise you that if you do this, you are going to see your life change for the better every single day. Psalms 56:3 says, when I am afraid, I put my trust in you. Today, let's choose to put our trust in Him, and let's allow God to build what only He can build in us and through us, one decision at a time. Somos, I am so excited for what God is going to do in us and through us. I believe that God is just giving us some practical ways for us to become better women and men of God. And so today, I just want to pray for you. And encourage you that you're not alone. You have a church family that loves you and wants to do life with you. So text us, call us if you need anything, and we can't wait to connect with you this week. Let's pray. God, I thank you so much for every single person that is watching today, God. I thank you, Jesus, that you are for us and that you are with us, God. I pray, Lord, that you will help us to make the right decisions, God, that you will help us to keep building in you one decision at a time, God. Help us to apply the practical tools that we have learned today to do what you're calling us to do tomorrow, God. I pray if there's anyone here, God, and maybe they're feeling shamed or they're feeling like they've messed up, God, I pray that they will just feel your grace right now, God. There is no decision that you cannot revoke, that you cannot turn around and use for good, God. And we just thank you that you're a good Father, that you love us so much, God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Thank you so much. We'll see you on Tuesday. We love you so much.